Jaida, Jaida, I'm so proud of you. This high school graduation is quite an accomplishment. I know it hasn't always been easy for you, but you have reached your goal. And we want to celebrate this great time with you. I was thinking what to say and brought me back to when you were just a baby and your mom and dad used to bring you over and the four of us would just sit there and you entertained us for hours, it seemed like. You just had such a sweet little spirit about you and I'll never forget those days. You were the firstborn grandchild, and oh my gosh, we were just so in love. I believe that your future is bright. God's got amazing things for you. Can't hardly wait to just move into this next season with you. We love you, baby. Like I said, I just can't wait to see what's in store. So congratulations and just be blessed.
Hi, Jaida. We are so proud of you, and I can't wait to see what God has in store for your life. I know you're going to do amazing things, and I'm just so blessed to be a part of your life and be called your godmother. Mwah. I love you.
Great job. We are so proud of you. We miss you. We love you. And just like Pamela was saying, remembering back when you were just a little baby, laughing and at everything that we said because you thought we were the funniest people of all time, and your mom can prove that and testify that we are funny. But we do love you, and I can't believe you've grown up, and I can't believe you graduated high school, and I can't wait to see what God does in this next season of your life. Congratulations.
We love you, Jaida Bob.
In order for me to kind of get through this without all that emotions, I'm going to need some help. So here we go. So I thought I'd get us an old friend to help us get all this sung through. My favorite, awesome, greatest granddaughter, oldest granddaughter. We've had fun times, sad times, great times, funny times, laughter times, sad times. That's how life goes, you know. Sure, what comes tomorrow. So you learn from the past and the present, what you've done, the tests that you've taken, the homework, and homework. Did I mention homework? And then there was that thing that jumped up in on you called senioritis. Oh my gosh, didn't know if we were gonna make it through there or not. But we survived, you survived, your choices. We just come alongside and help. We couldn't do it for you, but you did it. You did it, Jaida. And it's awesome to. So remember, if God's for you, who can be against you? Having known where you've been and those things we look at, we put in journals, we put in pictures, we put in things like this to remind us what God has brought us through and that we couldn't have made it without Him. And knowing that God is in your corner, knowing that your family's in your corner throughout your walk in this life helps to know that you are made more than a conqueror, not only in the past, but the present, and in the days that you're coming to, that we'll all get through this together, we'll all walk through it, and let your light shine, and know this, that it's been an incredible journey, and be all you can be in this life, and in the life that you got coming, the journey. Let it be something that gives you strength, peace, and restores those that cross your path. God says He never leaves nor forsakes you or us. Your value in looking at others and seeing the best in them and helping them see it is as well as an awesome gift, an encouragement gift, they say. You find the good in others, and Papa beams when he sees that. Sees the sacrifice. You think that they go unnoticed, that I want you to know that I see them, and I know the family sees those sacrifices that you've made. And they don't go unnoticed, especially with God. He knows all things. We can put our lives in His hands because He does. You can trust Him. Papa's compass is John 10:10, where it says that if a thought comes to mind and it gives a life, an abundant life, then you think on that, you plan it, you put it down, and you just work with it and make it grow. But if it's something that's going to steal your life, your joy, your peace, your comfort, and kill and destroy the things that God has placed in you, then you get rid of it. You throw it down, you stomp your feet, and it crushes the head of the enemy, but only bruises your heel in your walk. So enjoy the journey. Run your race, Jaida. Congratulations. Yeah, you hear the calves, they're even saying congratulations. Love you, Jaida. You make Papa real proud.
Dear Jaida, I'm not going to cry during this video. I don't cry. Anyways, I'm very proud of you for what you've done and what you've accomplished. It's only the beginning. I just want to congratulate you and tell you that you've done it and your dreams are there to catch. I'll always be here for you. I thank you for what you do and what you are, and I love you very much, and you're always my favorite, but really, I got three, so that don't count. But anyways, congratulations, your dad, bye.
Hi, Jaida. It seems like this time would never come, but now it seems like to me it's just come too quickly. We are so proud of the person you've become, your warmth, your caring, and the way you love so easily. Your great laugh makes us smile all the time.
While you searched for the things in your life that make you happy, we've seen you blossom. It's easy to see you having a lot of great successes ahead.
Love you, and we are so happy to be a part of your life and to watch your future unfold. Congratulations!
Congratulations!
Uncle Corey and Aunt Monica. You're graduating high school. That's awesome. We're really proud of you. Going out into the world and being an adult, you'll realize that everyone just acts like high schoolers.
And I want to say that I hope you loved high school. I loved it. But if you didn't, then there is a lot that life has coming to you. A lot of surprises and good things that I know you are going to enjoy, and opportunities that you're going to seize and make the most of. So we're really proud of you, like Corey said, and I'm just excited to see what you have for your next chapter. We love you.
Love you, Emily. Congratulations. We'll see you soon. Congratulations. Bye.
Hey, Jaida, just want to say congratulations. Can't believe you're already graduating from high school. That's amazing, and we wish you all the best, and we hope God watches over as you move forward in your life.
We are so proud of you, Jaida Harlene. We love you. Wish we could be with you. This has been a strange year, but we are so proud of you, honey. Love you.
Good luck, and God bless, hon. Take care. Love everybody up that way in the big state of Idaho.
Congratulations, Jaida, on graduating. I know that you're the smartest and patient and talented person I've ever met. I hope you have a nice life after today. And yeah, congratulations, Jaida.
Congratulations, Jaida, on having your graduation during such a weird, crazy year. Although it was cut short, I still hope that you had a wonderful year. Yay!
Yay!
Congratulations!
Congratulations! Woo! Congratulations, hope you're having a good day. Sorry we couldn't make it. We came down with a bad case of the masks.
Congratulations on graduating. I hope you're doing very well in Idaho.
Bye, love you so much.
Bye.
So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost.
Congratulations, Jaida. I heard you're graduating this year and I couldn't be prouder to say happy graduation and congratulations from one of the other awesome Jessies in your life.
What's up, Jaida? Just saying hi all the way from Las Vegas. But more than that, I want to wish you a happy graduation. Can't believe you're graduated. That's insane. That's so awesome. Just believe that God has a great future in store for you. And that I've gotten to witness just you stepping into some of that. And I just can't wait to see what he does. I believe that the best is yet to come for you. So just want to say congratulations. Wish you all the best. And I miss you a ton.
Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I.
You did it! Let's go!
Hello. Good job graduating, Jaida.
Tried carrying the weight of the world, but I only have two hands. Hope I get the chance to travel the world, but I don't have any plans.
Hello, Jaida. I know in this video we're all talking about where you're going and where you've been. I also would like to remind you of where you are right now, because when you go and you make your mark, you should always remember that this place where you are is where your family is, and it's always going to be here for you. There's always going to be a place somewhere in your life where people who love you are always waiting for you to visit. And I just hope that you never forget that, because life's going to be good and it's going to be hard. And I just want you to remember that during those hard times, you don't ever have to be alone. And you never have to be lost, because there's a place where you belong, and it's always going to be here. I know that your life has been so significant for us, but now it's going to take on a new kind of significance, because you're going to go out there and you're going to change the world in your own way that nobody else can. And I want you to know that I'm proud of you, and I'm proud of the person that you've grown into, and that I love you. And I thank God for having been blessed enough to have been a part of your life.
Jaida, what do I say on your graduation? I guess the first thing that comes to mind is how crazy proud I am of you. Your journey through traditional education has had a fair share or more of its trials and obstacles. While a couple of the obstacles may have slowed you down just a bit, you have overcame each and every single one of them. Romans 8 talks about obstacles, but it also talks about victory. If God is for you, who could be against you? You are an overcomer, and victory is yours. And today, that victory has you standing on the other side of high school,
as a graduate. You know, I remember standing in church with you as a little baby strapped on me so no one could hold you. I was totally that mom. Nana can attest to that. And you taught me so much. I know graduations are focused on what you learned, but I wanted to talk a little bit about what you've taught me over the years. The first one is easy. The different kind of love a mom feels for her baby is indescribable. When I found out I was pregnant with you, two overwhelming feelings hit me like a school bus. Overwhelming love for a baby that would change me into a mom, and terrorizing fear because I couldn't screw this up, but I knew I was gonna screw up. The idea of imminent failure was intimidating, to say the least. But I stood by 2 Timothy 1:7, and you know the scripture as well as I do. God hasn't given us a spirit of fear, but of power and love and self-control. The second thing that you taught me was to be fearless. When you were a toddler, we would go to the pool, and I had to make sure that you were ready to get into the water as soon as we get out of the car, because as soon as we walked through the gate, we would blink twice and you were in the water. I had to make sure that you had your water wings and your vest on and everything. You would take a wild leap into the water, laughing and giggling. You haven't outgrown that fear either. When you went down into the Cuna Caves without a second thought, or jumped up on the stage at Rolling Hills for the talent show and sang that Taylor Swift song. The whole school was watching you. It would have terrified me. But I love that you are fearless, and I love that you take risks. And I admire that about you so much. Another lesson that you taught me is to laugh more and enjoy life now. The first time you and Macy went off to church camp alone, you guys were probably 6 and 7 or 7 and 8. It was an elementary school camp, and I was a nervous wreck. And the only reason I wasn't going with you is because Cade was a baby. It was, I think, 3 or 4 nights, and it was the first time you had been away from me for that long. So I drove you guys up. I wanted to see where he was. I wanted to see I wanted to make sure everything was safe. And after I dropped you off, I watched desperately in my email for the daily updates that the camp leader had promised all of us nervous first-timers. Pia's email came through and talked about how nice the facility was and how all the kids had settled in just perfectly. Then she talked about the first evening service and how one of the girls had gone frog hunting earlier in the day and put dozens of little itty bitty frogs in her purse and then brought them to church for the evening service. And in the middle of service, all those little tiny frogs made their way out of that purse and hopped all over the sanctuary. I didn't even have to hear who it was. I knew it was you. And I knew my little adventure girl had gone out and enjoyed her afternoon with frog hunting. There's so much joy and laughter ahead of you, my girl. I'm so excited that I get to be in your space and in your face for this journey that we call life. I love you so much. You're gonna do amazing things. Stand on your faith always, but especially through the hard times, it will carry you. Call on God as much as you can. Stand on your scripture. Because he is faithful, this moment proves that. Congratulations, baby.